Welcome to News Once's, where we bring your neighborhood article to life. Gladys Berejiklian faces instability within as a COVID storm brews outside. The new South Wales Premier, Gladys Berejiklian, emerged from her crisis briefing at the Department of Health on Friday looking more stressed, with good reason. All the signs are that NSW is losing control of this outbreak of the Delta strain of COVID-19, despite the increasingly stringent lockdown rules. Regrettably, 29 of those were either partially or fully exposed to the community, Berejiklian, and that is the number that is really concerning us, Berejiklian. Cold, wet and windy weather ahead for Sydney could pose added risk in COVID lockdown. Read more. It tells us that both the case numbers and unfortunately the number of people who may be exposed or have been exposed in the community is going to go up. The number that should put fear into everyone is the 14,000 people who are under 14-day isolation orders as close contacts. That's doubled in 24 hours and is an indicator of how quickly the pool of exposed people can grow. The big unknown is how many have been exposed and not identified, given the public's somewhat lax approach to compliance with stay-at-home rules to date. It's a concerning time for all of us. This is not the time for complacency. Not the time to cut corners. If you like this video, please subscribe. We post more of what you like. Compliance is so important. Not only is Berejiklian battling the most serious outbreak of COVID that NSW has experienced and the added threat of the Delta variant, she is dealing with a new bout of destabilization from within her own ranks. The sniping and negative commentary is coming from disgruntled cabinet colleagues who seem intent on seizing on any setback to pour petrol on the fire. Those close to Berejiklian believe her own deputy, the Nationals leader, John Barilaro, is among those within cabinet who are unhelpfully briefing that a plan B is needed. Barilaro and Berejiklian's relationship reached a nadir last year, over the state's koala protections, taking the coalition to the brink of collapse. Berejiklian told Barilaro, if he continued with his threat to sit on the cross benches, he and his ministers could stay there. Barilaro took mental health leave, but in the following months has won some significant concessions on the protections.